Lewis, you look warm.
I'm still cold.
Yeah. How was the game? Go on then.
Game was frustrating. Game pisses me off even thinking about it.
I'm annoyed more than most times because you never know what can happen in these games. We haven't lost against them since 2002. Yeah, we've got a good record against them at the Bridge, and City drew today, which is a major advantage for us to go on and try and get ahead of them in top four.
Yep.
And we ain't done that really.
Yep. And we failed to capitalise on it. It's a poor performance from us. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. West Ham are shit. I don't care if they beat us 1-0. They're a shit team, and we really should have done better against them. And it pisses me off because I've been saying Giroud's is an option that we really should be using more for ages, and I feel like it's just been thrown back in my face. He was poor today, had the movement of a fridge, didn't do anything, the ball just kept bouncing off him. And I also think today Frank Lampard does have to take some of the blame today, because
I think he does today, sadly. I love Giroud, Frank, but you know.
Yeah, it's that Giroud substitution. Taking him off for Batshuayi, that's fine. We still got a focal point. You take him off and you don't bring on Batshuayi. Who came on? Was it Willian or Hudson-Odoi? You take him off and you bring Hudson-Odoi. You've got three players on the pitch up front who are under 6 foot. West Ham's game plan from them is piss easy because they've already got the win. All they're going to do is force us wide and make us put crosses in because we've got no one there who's going to be on the end of it. The last 15 minutes was just push the ball out towards the right-hand side, make Willian whip in across because it's not going to go anywhere, and then rinse and repeat and rinse and repeat. We could have played for another hour and we still wouldn't have scored another goal. Set pieces today as well, they were poor. Mount, Emerson, Willian looked like all three of them were competing for worst cross of the day. Every single corner was fucking terrible today. I'm not going to stand here and get too angry because, again, we're still a much better place than we expected to be, but when you've been playing this good for so long, you build a stat, you build a fucking status, you build a reputation for yourself. You want to keep building on it. What? Some pick up on what? Right. So the performance was frustrating, but like I said, Lampard only takes some of the blame for the substitution. I think it's also got something to do with fatigue as well, because we've been seeing this team. The team look tired out against Valencia as well, and they had an impact on the final result there. And you could see on some of the players, Reece James was at least a one positive of today. He was brilliant on that right hand side, and the only one who was actually whipping any decent crosses was him, and it was coming in on that right hand side. But even towards the end of the game, you could see it from him, he was getting gassed, he was getting tired, and you can see that rotation starting to become a problem for this side. I'm not that worried now, it's only for later, because you've just seen Tottenham have just revamped. They've got Jose. Arsenal finally got rid of Emery. I don't really rate Ljungberg that much, but you never know. It could be a same old resurgence that you see every time a team gets a new manager. And like you said earlier, Manchester City dropped points. This was an opportunity to build on that and capitalise. And we might have been above them if we had won today. But it's still a long season, so there's nothing too deep to worry about. It's just a frustrating game. Take it on to Aston Villa next. West Ham are still shit.